Welcome back, guys. We have a 14 card blind PSA reveal. I sent this in about 5 weeks ago, got it back already. I was told it would be August the 16th was the estimate, and it was back today, which ended up being, I believe, right at 5 weeks. So 5 weeks, not too bad. And I do have my pre-grades in front of me that I will read to everyone. I won't do any fancy editing. But before I get into it, I did also have a mail day reveal. And so I'm going to crack this mail day reveal open really briefly here as well. And then we will get right into the grade reveals. So 14 card, it's all baseball. Some older stuff, not what I would consider vintage. I think the special was from 1980. So I do have a 1980 Ricky Henderson. Most of the stuff is newer. There's some 86 tops as well, which I bought a vending box and decided to send in a few of those to see if I could actually gem some 86 out of a new box. But all right, we got a Tony Gwynn 87 Donruss autograph. So Tony Gwynn was one of my favorite players as a kid, obviously one of the great contact hitters ever. And I was really looking for a Tony Gwynn autograph, and I thought this 87 Donruss reminds me of my youth. And it's a fantastic condition autograph, and one day I might get that validated. But all right, let's jump right in. I'm just going to go in the order that they sent them back. These are not the order that I submitted. That's okay. The Pete Rose is an 86 Rose. I predicted that could get a 10, and I would not have been surprised if it's a 9. So let's see how close we were. That got an 8. So I can already see that this is not going to go well. They're going to be extremely tough on these older 86 cards. It's really a bit of an experiment to see if I could gem an 86, getting it out of the box, as 86s are very condition sensitive. All right, next I have a Bobby Witt. This is a 2022 Archives, I believe, and this is the image variation. Got a 9 on the variation. I had predicted a 10 on the Bobby Witt. So yeah, this is not going to be a good reveal. I can feel it already. It's gonna make me rethink sending junk in the future. I enjoy doing these, so I send them in, but if you're just going to get kicked in the junk repeatedly, I'm not going to continue. This is a Bowman's Best, I believe, Caden Wallace autograph, and that did get the 10. So probably the least valuable card in the submission got a 10, just par for the course. All right, next, another 86. This one is Iron Man Cal Ripken. I can see right here the tops of this card are yellowed like crazy, so or white, I guess. There's no way that's gonna gem, and I would challenge you to go back and look at my pre-grade video and look at the back of that Ripken and see. I don't think that was there. I really don't. I would have called it out, and as a result, it is an 8. The Ripken, I thought, had a solid chance at a gem as well. All right, next is another 86. This is a Don Mattingly. Got an 8. I'm thinking all these are just autopilot 8s. The Tony Gwynn, it's 7, even worse, just like I expected. Not going well. Let me pull the rest of these 86s. Let's just get them out of the way so I can throw all these slabs in the garbage and be done with it. Two more. All right, so we got the Kirk Gibson. This was another one that I had picked out of the box because I thought it could potentially have a good grade. Yeah, 7 on the Gibson. And lastly, the Nolan Ryan. Let's see if they give me a 4 on that one. An 8, okay. So the Ryan, I predicted that I would probably get an 8. I said I would not be surprised if it came back a 9, but I graded it an 8. It was off-center. Otherwise, it was in really nice condition. So all in all, disappointed in the 86s. I really thought I could gem at least 2 of those. I knew it would be tough, but I thought I could get a couple. Anyway, whatever, moving on. 2023 Bowman. This is a Myro Shendrick Martinez. This is a numbered rookie, or first, not a rookie, a first auto, and that got a 9. I believe I had predicted a 10 on that one. All right, next, I'm gonna save the last two here. These are the ones that I cracked out of existing slabs. What do I wanna do next? All right, I had a Mikel Garcia. This is also a first auto. And this is a 2022, and that one did get a gem. So it seems like the two that I probably would have picked as my least favorite to get gems did. Let me move this up a little bit. There we go. All right, and next we have a NPB Yamamoto. This was the 86 Topps refractor. I really liked the look of this card. I had predicted that it would get a 9, and it got a 10. So there's a pleasant surprise. So this is the other thing with PSA. It seems like they really have really over-rotated towards the modern stuff. Like the modern stuff seems to grade out so much better than the vintage stuff with PSA. I don't really get that philosophy. I know SGC is generally known as the better grader for anything considered vintage, which I consider pre-90 as vintage. I know most people say pre-80, but SGC is a very tough grader, but it seems like they're more consistent on the older stuff. So maybe I'll keep that in mind in the future. All right, and then I've got a Cole Reagans. This is a Stadium Club auto. 2023 rookie auto numbered out of 50, 34 to 50. I predicted a 9 on the Reagans and I got an 8. So I did actually say it could be an 8 on that Reagans because I wasn't sure if a couple of the marks that I saw on it were actually like, you can see the little white marks there. I didn't know if those, that was part of like just the image of the card and all of them have it, or if it was something dinged up on there. I do like Reagans. I'm a Royals fan, and so I was excited to see what that one got. I really did think that I was going to sneak out a 9, but I thought it could definitely get an 8, so not that surprised on that one, honestly. Okay, and next I've got the Juan Soto. This is a Heritage, Topps Heritage rookie card, 2018, I believe, and the Soto was originally in a GMA slab as a 10, and PSA agreed. So there you go. GMA said it's a 10. PSA also said it's a 10. So there's a pleasant surprise. All right, now is going to be the big test. So I took quite a risk and ripped a Ricky Henderson rookie card, 80 tops, out of an SGC 7 slab, which SGC 7 is not bad for that card. I actually sent that in raw to get that 7. And I thought, you know what? Let's see, now that PSA owns SGC, let's see if they agree. What's it going to be? Oh, it upgraded to an 8. So there you go. I'll take that all day of the week over these junk 86 cards. I upgraded my Ricky from a SGC 7 to a PSA 8. I am jazzed about that. Kind of makes it all feel worth it in the long run. So anyway, got four 10s, which out of this kind of unusual order, I'm pretty happy with, and got, let's see, two 9s, and then a variety of 8s, so yeah, not too bad. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you have not seen the pre-grade, you can go see what my delusions were back in that one, and yeah, give me your thoughts below. I always love getting everybody's feedback. You can roast me if you want to as well. I don't mind, and I understand. All right, we'll talk to you guys soon.